An architect is the person whose thoughts interfere with the life of every person on the face of the earth. It is he who constitutes the void in which any person lives in existence. It constitutes the void of the home, school, hospital, office, club, airport, shops, and even prisons. A person can hardly leave a building designed by an architect except to enter another building designed by another architect. The architect is the one who forms the void of buildings from the inside and their shape from the outside and defines, draws and directs the movement of people in it and the movement of users of these buildings. If the school design is a good example of natural lighting, the ventilation and elevations are appropriate for the student's age, the users of the building, and their movement in it. This will be reflected positively on their educational attainment, and vice versa is completely correct. Or the success of their treatment, therefore, the experience and competence of the architect designed for any project will be directly reflected on human and human societies. Rather, the architect is the one who makes the civilization of peoples and their advancement and civilization because the individual, when he visits any country for the first time in his life, he will directly judge the civilization of this country or its backwardness from form and coordinate its buildings, airport and streets. Before it deals with its people or even speaks one word to any of its citizens. One of the problems that an architect faces when designing a building is the problem of traditions, and he must understand the traditions in order for his project to come up with an understandable message. However, these traditions change with time and with the place and medium in which they originated. These factors cause the engineer to ask about how these traditions originated and what is the function of these traditions and how they were able to continue and survive or even how they were replaced by other traditions, and in all these cases it tries to he finds the answer to these questions so that he can either accept it, reject it or adopt a compromise that he adheres to when designing his building. And the architect, although working within the limits of the civilization of his time, but as a human being he cannot get rid of his natural tendency to understand the past and belong to him in addition to what he learns from the social behavior in which he lives and which is based on traditions, values and beliefs through which he feels that he belongs to the world. Although these factors combined may affect its design without awareness of it, some believe that traditions are things that have passed away and have been folded in the pages of history and they are present only in history books and can be referred to in the picture and the book. Those who call for this resort to the world, analyze information about the environment and the past, set out theories and describe the scientific information and the necessary sizes. However, this codification is not accessible to all members of society, and understanding the design is not a part of their lives and their imaginations. Therefore, the designer under these conditions becomes the specialist who lacks an understanding of the natural and historical development of the place where he will construct the building. The designer can acquire knowledge of this synchronization by studying and understanding the traditions that prevail in the place where he will design, and without this it will be difficult to understand the function of the place and therefore it is difficult to understand the architectural design itself. The reason for not caring about the historical and natural development of the place is due to the desire to benefit from the forces of society, including its artisan art and the ability to produce. I wanted the community to see its future in industrialization and that life will develop to the best with technology. People have been dazzled by the technology and the economic benefits that resulted from it, and the architects were no less enthusiastic about them. They turned to technology and neglected the styles, and they looked at those who put decorations on the facades as a criminal process. Instead of the architect looking at the works of Michelangelo and the Gothic cathedrals, he replaced that by looking at the planes and machines to take inspiration from, and these were for the following reasons. The architect was forced to use discovered materials such as glass, iron and reinforced concrete to find solutions to the design problems, as was the pressure on him to house large numbers of workers displaced to the cities, and therefore he was forced to break old architectural traditions and traditional solutions that have historical origins and precedents. The new tone at that time was the secretariat of the job, the secretariat for expressing construction materials and the secretariat for expressing the structural elements of the building, and the decorations have fallen victim to these logos because the motifs and ornaments do not serve a functional purpose. They cited Darwin's theory that says that a person evolves if the environment changes for the better, and the belief was then that technology would be the decisive factor in progress, and therefore aesthetic factors and social traditions became irrelevant. The beauty of the machine became desirable in itself, and the beauty of the machine was a result of simplicity and geometry, and the function of the machine became the argument used by the architects to explain the reasons for their preference for aesthetic values, and thus the walls were stripped of their decorations and the rooms were open to each other, and the buildings in this medium became like the machine and had engineering forms that do not have a relationship or a historical precedent, and the trend towards modular design became the result of applying a set of principles and theories. As a result, it created a modern, rational architecture that applies globally. This has led to the emergence of boredom cities with monotonous buildings that have a personality that is far from the architect's special touches. Unjust attack. The matter has reached such an extent that the attack on the job has become the same. Schindler said in 1912 that the job is nothing but a hollow slogan that was used to urge traditional adherents to use contemporary technical methods. Friedrich Kiesler was fed up with the modern movement in architecture. We don't need new ideas, no matter how smart they are. Instead of a single facade, a bug in the old building is replaced by four sleek facades? And instead of Baroque lines, straight lines? And instead of rectangular windows, square windows? And instead of art architecture? Have the experts gone bankrupt? Let it all go. Forsaken life. The question now comes. Did the engineers achieve the life that the people who inhabited the homes that were designed for them in the modern style were expected of them? Theoscorpion says that the lives of people in these dwellings have not only become desolate and depressing, but are also socially ostracized, and that the economic factor is what prevented those interested in finding an alternative means of housing, and the missing element became the close relationship between people and each other as well as the environment around them, and as a result, a split occurred between the supporters of the modern movement themselves in the Siam Conference that was held in 1953. Many young engineers met after it became certain that the Siam Conference in Athens, which had previously taken place in 1933 when modern theories crystallized to doctrines and decided to call themselves the title of Team 10, was mandated by Siam to prepare them for Righteousness X program for them, which was scheduled to take place in the city of De Prevenc, was the project filed by the then It focuses attention on human beings and participation environment, more attention to what is called the job, and I've seen it change radically in the contemporary architecture thinking. Thus, these architects expressed the feeling that the early pioneers were not successful in solving the human problem with architecture. Proline cites an example of what is happening to a city designed without observing the traditions that govern people. This city is Chandigarh, designed by Le Corbusier at the request of Nehru, Prime Minister of India, that the city be created on the occasion of India obtaining its independence. Nehru wanted to lead India away from the past of Indian colonialism and traditions, and therefore gave Le Corbusier a hand to do whatever he wanted in the city to become one of the finest cities. Le Corbusier's idea of designing the city was similar to what Perry advocated in the late 19th century, and which proposed the residential neighborhood as a principle of planning. His idea is to allocate a limited residential space surrounded by roads and mediated by public services and an elementary school frequented by neighboring children, as well as separating pedestrian roads from motorways, and making the entrances of houses open to parks and public corridors, and linking these houses from behind with streets connected to the main roads to facilitate the access of cars to these housing from behind. It has resulted in the protection of children who play in front of their homes from the dangers of cars. In addition, the elementary school in the neighborhood did not go to many of their children because the Indian families send their children according to their social levels to private schools that are far from the region, and the school has not become the nucleus of society as it exists in Western societies. As for the commercial area, most of the shops are a kind of shops that cluster together, and when this happened in Chandigarh, a vacuum arose as a result of the lack of other services necessary for the daily life of the residents, and it was not possible to bridge this shortage without the appearance of itinerant vendors who set up quick kiosks on the streets. Aka and transformed gradually into a market for their trade and filled the garden and turned into garbage bins and empty cages and piles of goods scattered everywhere. And Le Corbusier's planning was supposed to be in one side of the road, so that people would not cross the road in numerical times, traveling from a store to a store, so what was the result? The houses on the side facing the shops have been turned into shops. As for the design of residential units, the interior has changed a lot after it was inhabited by more than one family, which in some cases reached three and four families. The main reason for the failure of Chandigarh was its lack of Indian character, and therefore Indians could not live in the city as planned by Le Corbusier. Call of the place. The architects thought that their rejection of the old traditional buildings and laying modern foundations for design means that people will change their traditions that they inherited and continue on, but people have always corrected their homes from within to bring them in line with their social requirements. Engineers thought that the industrial renaissance would benefit all people, and thus they did not pay attention to the category that remained unchanged, thinking that they were on the way to a transformation. It was the belief that entering into the era of technology would reduce the number of family members, and this was one of the pillars of the Bauhaus defense when working their housing programs. The question that arises now is, how can an architect understand the call of the place? Every place has events and memories of features, and these are all remaining, even if superficial changes occurred in the place, and the architect can extract it from the reality of people's clear expression that appears in their relationships with each other and what appears to them as an expression of their requirements. For example, we find in the countryside that people sit in front of the entrances to their homes talking to their neighbors, so it is the duty of the architect in this case to understand these social relationships and design homes so that their entrances converge. We also find that people consider the street facing their homes to be an extension of the living hall, encouraging their children to play in it while they are watching them from their windows with the upper floors, so the architect must create these conditions for them without exposing them to accidents, especially from the passage of vehicles, and if the neighborhood's people want to be near some of them and not harm them hustle, it would not be appropriate to provide the area with wide streets, open courtyards or vast gardens. The majority of city dwellers currently do not have the conditions to use the services of servants, and the housewife was forced to spend long times inside the kitchen, so it is more appropriate for the kitchen to take a different situation from the past, and that its design come to allow the housewife to monitor the rest of the house from its location and believe in it as a place to eat. Members of the house have food in it. This becomes important in the event that the family is unable to use the dining room while guests are due to the opening of the living room, and avoid the embarrassment that may occur. Emotional relationship with the place. Knowing the place is supposed to be more than just the natural phenomena on the site, it is a process that needs to be thought from the designer engineer so that he can have an emotional relationship with the place. Also, getting to know the place is also not enough. Rather, it is necessary for the architect to take a step towards confronting the traditions in this place. That is, the engineer, who is on the site and facing him, must adopt a specific position, and he is in his position to decide whether he should accept the traditions or reject it. These identification and confrontation processes are successive strategies to ensure assimilation of the situation, and thus the design achieves its goal and comes clear and understandable. That confrontation necessitates investigation and asking questions to know the nature of traditions in the place, questions that have to do with the function of the building and the way in which traditions have been able to access why as a society and how it might continue and how it has evolved. From here it can be concluded that the process of developing a direct sense of place is the task of the design engineer. This task is difficult because it is not required to collect information or scientific material, but that the task itself is a strategy of knowledge. It is important to take into account that the intervention of the designer on the site will result in visual facts that affect the region, whether better or worse. Therefore, he is solely responsible for the damage that will result in the area if he does not understand the problem. From this angle, we can say that the theory of traditions is in this case a general strategy and not design methods. It is a kind of mental process that enables us to test our position on the environment and society before we risk the imposition of design and its implementation on site. Thank you. Don't forget to like and subscribe me. ArchShaza.